for thermosetting plastic. Thermoplastics, thermosetting plastics. Phenol formaldehyde resins are phenoplast. Phenoplast. So here, these are condensation polymerization products of phenolic derivatives with aldehydes, which are prepared by condensing phenol with formaldehyde in presence of acid or alkaline catalyst. In presence of acid or alkaline catalyst, depending on the catalyst and reactants, mainly three kinds of resins are formed. They are Nolac resins. Nolac resin is formed when phenol and formaldehyde condense to form Nolac resin. Phenol and in the presence of acid, phenol and formaldehyde condense to form Nolac resin. This is the phenol. This is the formaldehyde condense. Orthomethyl phenol, paramethyl methylal phenol. These are condensed. Orthomethylal and then phenol condense and gives Nolac resin. Resol resin. Phenol and formaldehyde are reflexed with ammonia at 100 degrees gives resol resin. So in the Nolac resin, in presence of acid, phenol and formaldehyde, same. So here mixture of orthomethylal phenol, paramethylal phenol is formed. Nolac resin is formed. Then in the resol resin, monomethylal phenol, phenol and formaldehyde are reflexed with ammonia. This is the basic medium. At 100 degrees gives resol resin in presence of ammonia. Methylal phenol have greater reactivity with formaldehyde than phenol. Hence it gives di and trimethylal products. So here only either orthomethylal or paramethylal products are formed. So in the basic medium, this is the monomethylal phenol further react with formaldehyde gives dimethylal phenol. Dimethylal phenol further react with another formaldehyde gives trimethylal phenol. Trimethylal phenol. So the polymethylal phenol, it's maybe di or tri, condenses and forms resol resin. So this is the resol resin. Trimethylal phenol condenses gives resol resin. Bakelite. Bakelite was first prepared in the backland in the presence of hexamethylene tetramine. No resol resin is formed. Nolac resin is formed in the presence of acidic acid. Resol resin is formed in the presence of ammonia as a basic medium. Bakelite is formed in the presence of hexamethylene tetramine. You have to remember hexamethylene tetramine. In the presence of hexamethylene tetramine, phenol react with formaldehyde. Phenol react with formaldehyde and forms cross-linked resins. That is bakelite. It is hard and insoluble solid. It is very hard and insoluble solid. This is the phenol. You can see C6H5OH. Phenol. Two molecules of phenol condense with one molecule of formaldehyde. In the phenol, one hydrogen atom of one phenol, another hydrogen atom of another phenol, then oxygen of formaldehyde removed as a water molecule in the condensation reaction, and in presence of hexamethylene tetramine gives, see here, this hydrogen is removed, bond is formed here with this CH2. Here, this phenol, everything is as well as here. This hydrogen is removed, here this hydrogen is removed, in between these two, CH2 is added. Same thing, here also CH2 is added. Like this, this will be continued, this side also continue. Then cross-linked polymers are formed. Here also, here in between these two, same chain is formed, this side also, same CH2. In between these two phenols, CH2, but cross-linked. So here one CH2 is joined, here also one CH2 joined, here. This is the backlight. In presence of hexamethylene tetramine, phenol react with formaldehyde and forms cross-linked resins. Cross-linked polymer, that is known as backlight. This is the backlight, cross-linked polymer. But here, for formation of this chain, for each two phenols, one formaldehyde is participating. Here also same. For combining of, for linkages, here also further one more formaldehyde is for participating. So this is the cross-linked polymer. It's very hard thermosetting plastics. What are the properties of these thermosetting plastics? So Novolac resin is soluble and fusible solid. Resol resin is hard and brittle solid. You have to remember, Novolac resin is soluble and fusible solid. Resol resin is hard and brittle solid. Bakelite is a rigid, hard, infusible, water resistant, and insoluble solid. Bakelite is a rigid, hard, infusible, water resistant, and insoluble solid. That's why it has the greatest importance. It is resistant to non-oxidizing agents, salts, and organic solvents, but are attacked by alkalis due to presence of free hydroxyl group. Free hydroxyl groups. All phenol formaldehyde resins possess excellent electrical insulating character. This is the important character, important property of the phenol formaldehyde resins, electrical insulating character. Bakelite is a rigid, hard, infusible, water resistant, and insoluble solid. What are the applications? Uses. Making electric insulator parts like switches, plugs, switchboards, heater, handles, etc. Because this is the thermosetting, then having high resistance to heat, I mean hard, infusible, water resistant, everything. Preparing molded articles like telephone parts, cabinets for radio and television. Impregnating fabrics, wood and paper as adhesives for grinding wheels. Making bearing used in the propeller shaft for paper industry and rolling mills as hydrogen exchanger resin in water softening. So all these are the important properties of bakelite. So bakelite is prepared with phenol and formaldehyde in presence of hexamethylene tetramine.